Hi and welcome back to our channel. So today let's discuss about OD14 fiscal localization package for Mexico accounting. So Mexico localization provides accounting features required for the companies operating in Mexico. So chart of accounts and tax are automatically generated along with the localization. So with this localization, ODO will help the company to perform the accounting activities defined in the ODO using the rules and regulations defined by Mexico localization. So the first step is to install the localization modules from the ODO app store. So we can close this apps filter and can search for the country name. Okay, so basically we have four modules. So at the time of database creation, if the country is chosen as Mexico, then it will automatically install Mexico accounting features, or you can manually install it from here. So you can see I have already installed the modules. So here we have main module Mexico accounting, which includes the basic configuration needed to operate a company in Mexico, like basic accounting features, chart of accounts, taxes, fiscal positions, and some legal statements. And then we have a module that is EDA for Mexico, that is Mexico localization for EDA documents. So it supports all electronic transactions, that is CFDI 3.2, which is electronic invoice by internet, then 3.3, then payment complement, invoice addendum. And we have localization reports, Mexican reports. So you can see two modules. So it is mandatory, that is for mandatory electronic accounting reports. So the first one, it is a electronic accounting report, COA, that is trial balance DIOT report. Then another, the second one, it allowed to generate the trial balance for closing entry. Okay. Then we have ODO Mexico localization for stock or landing. So this module extends the functionality of Mexico localization to support customs numbers related with landed cost when you generate the electronic invoice. So you can see when you install the EDA for Mexico, that is advanced features, you can see it will, this module will be automatically installed. Then in Mexico from 2011, the electronic invoices are in CFDI format. So it means a digital fiscal document through internet, that is invoices. So for CFDI, invoice must have the signature of exhibitor and signature of the certification provider, PAC. So, and CFDI 3.2 format was used until 2017, December 31st. And after that, rule was changed. So as per rule, CFDI 3.3 format has to be used from January 2018. And this CFDI format is supported by ODO version 11 and above. So to enable CFDI for lower ODO versions, one has to upgrade their ODO SaaS instant version to version 11 or above. Okay. So now we are using ODO version 14. So to enable the electronic invoice, after installing the module, we have to go to accounting configuration settings, and there you can find an option to enable this electronic invoicing. So you can see it is already enabled Mexican electronic invoicing to create your electronic invoices automatically in CFDI format. Okay, so on enabling this option, it will automatically create it in this format, and that is a signed invoice, CFDI 3.2 and 3.3, and signed payment complement, CFDI 3.3 only. So, and this is also integrated with ODO's normal invoice flow. Okay, so first let's configure a company before making accounting entries. So for that, we can go to settings. And then we can manage our companies. Okay, so I have already configured company. I've provided address with country, state, and email, website. So here you can add a VAT number. Okay, so now let's save this. So we can switch to the company. We can go to accounting. So here you can find an option to set the fiscal localization, that is taxes, fiscal positions, chart of accounts and legal statements for your country can be set from here. So here you can see that package. After setting the package, you can save the settings. Okay, so you can see the localization specific chart of accounts, taxes, journals, fiscal positions. So when you open chart of accounts, you can see the accounts set for the company. So you can make them active and you can also disable them. The same way we have taxes, journals, then fiscal positions. Okay, so you can here add the tax mapping and account mapping. Okay, now let's go to a partner form. And here we can set some fiscal position for the partner contact. So here under sales and purchase, you have an option to set the fiscal position for the customer. Okay, so you can add that. And you can also see all the details entered while creating the company, so which is already filled. So let me open the contact. Okay, Cybrosis Technologies. So you can see these details were filled at the time of company creation. So you can see the VAT number. And here we can see an additional field CURP. So it is an 18 digital alphanumeric code of population registration used in Mexico to identify the residents and Mexican citizens. And under sales and purchase tab, okay, we have, again, you can set the fiscal position. So you can set the fiscal position for your company and to add by default the external trade complement in invoice for this customer, check the option need external trade here. And then under accounting tab, you can also find some additional options, additional fields. So here when you add bank account, can select the bank, then account number, add account number. And here you have an option to add CLABE. And below there is an option to add DIOT information. So the CLABE number is an 18 digit code used in Mexican banks and that contains the information of the bank. So its branch location as well as the individual account number used for safe transfer of payments. And this DIOT information, it indicates the operation types that make this supplier. So in the reporting side, we will acquire these details too. So you can add the type of operation from here. Now let's check the system parameters and see how we can enable CFDI 3.3. For that, first of all, we have to enable the developer mode. So from below, we can activate the developer mode. Now go to technical. System parameters. Create a new one. You can provide the version 3.3, and after that you can save this from here. So one of the most important things to be noted for when enabling the CFDI 3.3 is that your tax VAT 16% and 0% factor type is TESA. So here from accounting, you can configure our taxes. Okay, so you can see the factor type is TESA. And for this also, 0% also, you can see the factor type is set as TESA. So this indicates the factor type that is applied to the base of tax. Now let's see how we can configure PAC to sign invoices properly. So we can go to configuration settings to set that, to configure that. So PAC, the authorized certification provider, is one of the greatest moves in Mexico for digital invoicing. So actually what happens is that the invoice tax valuation is done separately, which is an advantage for both clients and the SAT. As the validation was assigned to an approved third party, that simplifies the procedure and reduces the dependence on all the invoices to be validated by tax authority. So here you can see max PAC. So we can add the PAC from the list of PAC providers. So you can see the list here. And we can also provide the PAC username, then password. Okay. And another way is that we can use a test environment. That is, you can see MX PAC test environment. So then no need to add the username or password. It will use the test credentials. Okay, then we can add the fiscal regime to configure the SAT fiscal regime. So here we can select from here. And then we can also add MX certificate. So here you can see option to configure your SAP certificate. So here we can create a new one. You can provide this, upload the certificate key, then password, certificate password, and you can save. So multiple MX certificate can be added from here. Okay, so after adding this, you can save the settings. Now let's see how invoicing is done for Mexican localization. So it is same as that of Odoo invoice. That is, the procedure is same as that of Odoo invoice. So let's create a new invoice from here. Okay, we can select the invoice date, due date. So you can see some additional fields here. One is a payment way, which indicates the way that the invoice will be paid. It can be through cash, bank transfer, or check or credit card. And if it is unknown, then you can leave this field empty. So you can see by default, one method is chosen here. Then we have payment policy. So it is updated once invoice is confirmed. That is to either PPD or PUE. So you can see one is set PUE, and this is assigned based on the payment terms. So if the payment term is not defined, it takes the payment policy as PUE. And on the other hand, it will be considered as PPD. Then we have a field that is usage. So this is used in CFID 3.3. That is used to express the key to the usage that we give the receiver of the document. Then we can add payment reference, that is which used to set on the journal. Then we have a field that is CFDI origin. So it is used at the time when payments, credit or debit notes, invoices are re-signed or invoices that are redone. So due to payment in advance, we will need to fill this field. And here we can add invoice lines. Okay, so from here we can confirm the invoice. Okay, you need to define a UNPC product category for these products. So this code is related to the product and it is used for electronic invoicing in Colombia, Peru, and Mexico. So here, we have to choose one. Okay, so you can see a message shown, the invoice will be sent asynchronously to CFDI 3.3. And you have an option to send it right now. And you can see the electronic invoicing status is set as to send. Then SAT status is not synchronize yet. So you can click on the send now. So you can see some error has occurred because we haven't configured the certificate, no valid certificate found. Okay, so we have to configure that. And here you can see an option to print invoices without payment and with payment. So when you click on that, here we can open this invoice. Okay, so here we can see signature of this invoice is required, but it is not signed. So if SAT is correctly synchronized and confirmed in the invoice, electronic invoice with signature can be seen. Okay, so in this case, it is not synchronized. Now let's move on to our accounting reports. So in order, we have some default reports. So along with that, we have some localization specific reports for country, Mexico. So you can see there are four reports. So first one, we have a trial balance report. So when it comes to trial balance, details of each account balance, debit, credit values, and total are shown. And from here, the data can also be exported to XML or XLS format. So you can see that options. And we have a lot of filtering options based on time period, and we can compare with previous period. Then we can filter this by journal, analytic account. Then if you want to view unposted entries, you can also click on that option. Okay. Then we have trial balance month 13. So this report is same as a trial balance. It defines the credit debit values of accounts. It also gives a description of the trial balance, including the total assets, total liabilities, and current benefit. And this will be shown at the end of the report. Then we have COA. So all the chart of accounts can be viewed here, and also the journal entries and journal items can be viewed. And it can be exported in both XLS or XML format. So one of the basic configuration is the creation of chart of accounts. So we can configure chart of accounts. We have seen it from here under accounting. You can configure chart of accounts. So in this case, we have a format that is nnn.yy.zz, where nnn.yy is a coding group of SAT. So once you enter the code, and while creating, adding the account name and tag gets auto-filled. So these tags, like here we have tags. So these tags are set for assigning in custom reports. So in the COA report, each chart of accounts are shown with the tags. And there are tags already mentioned by SAT for each account. So they are automatically added with COA while installing the localization package. So one can create and also one can create custom tags on fly. So here we have an option to create custom tags, and we can add the applicability that is on accounts or taxes. Okay, so you can see the tags here. So we can view the general ledger. Okay, then we have a report that is transactions with third parties, that is DIOT. So this reporting, accounting application. So DOT is an informational statement of operations with third parties, and it is an added VAT requirement that one must send their suppliers the status of activities to third parties. So inside the partner form, we have seen under accounting tab, the DIOT information like nationality and operations Here we can see the nationality and the operation, type of operation. So for suppliers, the type of operation is a mandatory field. So have to provide this type of operation for suppliers. So these are the additional reporting. Then, so we have gone through the additional features available in Mexican accounting localization package. So that's all in this video, and thanks for watching. Thank you.